Hello, this is Professor Bustillo-Booth, and in this video tutorial, I'll walk you through how to submit your assignments in Canvas. I'll be using a class for our example, but all the steps will be relevant for all of my classes. I will also be walking you through three scenarios involving submissions where one is successful, another is when a student attempts to resubmit an assignment only to find that they're missing a document, which will be the task of the third scenario, which is to complete all of the submissions that are required for the class so that they can get credit for an on-time submission. All right, let's go ahead and begin. For this demonstration, I'm using Management 186 as our example. However, all of the steps that I show you will be relevant for the courses I teach. Now, there are multiple ways to find the assignment that you're looking for. One of which is to click Grades, which will have a list of all the assignments that you will be graded against for the rest of the course. Now, this can be lengthy and it might be difficult to find the assignment. And so what I typically like to do is go to Modules and look for it in the week in which it's due. And I become aware of that because I've been following through in the course week by week. So in this case, I'm going to use the example of an assignment in week 7 called Application Process Part 2. Go ahead and click that. Then the assignment level will show up and it will have all the instructions on how to complete this assignment. Of course, you will read through all of the instructions and follow it closely. Now, it's fairly important to be aware what exactly needs to be submitted. And so in this case, in number 8, if I were to scroll down here, you can see that there are actually two documents that need to be submitted, a worksheet in Word form and a resume in PDF. So you'll want to make sure that's exactly what you are submitting. And in some assignments, you'll only be submitting one document, and that's fine. Just make sure you understand that the system is looking for a type of document. So for example, the settings for this assignment will not accept PowerPoint or Excel or a text only. It has to be Word and it has to be PDF. Let's go ahead and show you how to submit the assignment itself. Now, you are looking at a desktop, and so things are laid out pretty nicely here with all of the content visible to you. If you are using a smartphone to upload your document, it may look very differently. Or if you're using a different browser other than Chrome, it may look differently. But these buttons are there. You'll need to scroll around and make sure you can find it. And so in order to submit, you'll need to click that button and it'll reveal this area where you can then upload your documents. And it'll give you several options. One is to upload your file, typically from your device, or you can go to the cloud, a Dropbox or Office 365 or OneDrive. I'm going to go ahead and upload using the file upload option. I'll choose a file, which happens to be in my download, and I will look for that document that I want to upload, right? And I'll click on that icon, click open, and it is now staged, not yet submitted, but staged to upload. And you can see that when I hover over this, the full name of the document is shown. And that's important because you want to make sure the document that you intend to upload is the document that is staged to upload. Okay. Now, this assignment had a second document that needed to be uploaded. So I'll want to go ahead and click the Add Another File. I'll choose a file and then I'll click and open. And then, you know, have it staged and then take a look and see if that's the document that I actually wanted to be up there. And I notice here as I hover that it is not. It is another resume, probably an earlier version, and it is a document. DOC or DOX is a Word document. I'm like, no, that's not what I wanted. So you'll want to X that out and then try again, add another file. In this case, I'll look a little bit more closely and go, oh yeah. That's the one I want, that PDF. I'll click on that and click open. And then that document is now staged. And just to be sure, that's what I'm looking for. All right, so that is the one. I want the resume in a PDF format, all right? And if you wanna go ahead and add a comment, you can do that there. You can say, for example, I really enjoyed this assignment. Ta-da! All right, so then you can click Submit Assignment, which takes a little bit of time to complete. So you'll want to wait to make sure this process completes itself, right? Don't walk away and or do something else. Or if you're doing your phone, don't think that because you click submit, somehow it completed. You do need confirmation that the submission has been turned in and that the documents you expected, both of them actually uploaded. It may be that only one of them uploaded. It is your responsibility to make sure that each and every single document in the proper format did load, all right? Not the system's responsibility, but yours. That's why you need to go back and make sure that what you intended actually did happen. Okay, now you could also resubmit the assignment if you wish. Say, for example, that you know you had a lot of time left and you realize that, oh, you know, I need to correct that. Those documents, and then you can go and resubmit the assignment, you know, choose another version. Let's just say, for example, this is an updated version. Click the open, and then you'll want to write a comment that say something like, please ignore the earlier version of my worksheet or my resume, whatever it might have been, and use this one for grading purposes. Okay, it'll be important for you to write that, and then you will submit that assignment, right? And again, you will wait to make sure the process completes itself, and then now you have a documentation that you submitted that one document. Now you can see here there's only one document that was submitted, and so the PDF is now not visible, right? So you'll say to yourself, oh my gosh, I did that wrong. I need two documents. You can resubmit again. And this time correctly, you do your worksheet, you add another file, and let's assume that this is an updated file, and you'll hover over to make sure that is what you wanted. Hover over and make sure that is what you want in PDF form. And then you'll say, my apologies. This is the set I would like graded. Okay, you need to be very clear. And then you'll submit that. And you wait for the process to complete. And what you see here as the last documents that you've submitted will be the ones that I get to see for submission purposes, for grading purposes, and especially for peer reviews. You'll want to make sure, right, in this case it's peer review, that if you are making a correction in terms of your submission, that you submit both documents again. Otherwise, that other one is going to be hidden. They would have been overwritten to reveal this one. Okay, so you want to make sure it's very clear that the documents that you are submitting, both of them are visible to you as your last submission. All right, so if you have any questions, please make sure you email me. I am happy to clarify. Thank you so much for watching.